Good morning, everybody. Today we are discussing the next topic of the nuclear chemistry, that is neutron to proton ratio or N by P ratio and the nuclear stability. So the stability of the nucleus is determined by the number of the neutrons and protons present inside the nucleus. So for a lower atomic number nuclei, that is the atomic number up to 29, the nucleus is highly stable. So for this type of the nucleus, the N by P ratio is very much close to the 1. But for higher atomic number, then that means the atomic number greater than 29, the N by P ratio is greater than 1. So for that type of the nucleus, the neutrons are excess, and while we are increasing the neutrons, the attractive force increases and the proton-proton repulsion inside the nucleus decreases. Okay, proton-proton repulsion inside the nucleus decreases. So then naturally the stability increases. See here, this is a graph showing the N by P ratio. We can see the two straight line. One is passing through the origin, that is a straight line, and having the equation m is equal to y is equal to mx plus c, and which is passing through the origin 0. And the dotted line shows the N by P ratio of the nucleus. See here, for the up to atomic number 29, I have shown by a circle. Up to 29, the N by P ratio line and the straight line is very much close to each other. That means it is coinciding, which shows that N by P ratio is equal to 1. But whereas as we increase the atomic number from 29, the N by P ratio line is slightly deviating from the straight line. That means the N by P ratio is above than 1, and up to 1.4 it is stable nuclei, and that's why it does not eliminate any radiation. This region is known as the belt of stability. So up to the belt of stability, the nucleus is stable and it will not emit any radiation. So beyond that, nucleus is unstable and it readily eliminate the radiation. So consider this, for N by P ratio greater than 1.5, the nucleus is very heavy and the nucleus is stable also. For example, lead, mass number 208. I'm not bothering about the atomic number, because for 82, the atomic number 82, the element must be lead. So I am only bothering about the mass number. So lead at mass number 208 and bismuth mass number 209 is highly stable, but they are heavy nucleus. But even then it is stable. So that means we can conclude that for up to N by P ratio 1.5, it is stable. So above to that, this nucleus, the nucleus is unstable and radioactive to attain the favorable N by P ratio. And we have already studied the three different type of the decay: alpha decay, beta decay and gamma decay. For alpha decay occurs the nucleus greater than atomic number 82 and mass number 208. So for the alpha decay, N by P ratio rises. During alpha decay, the nucleus, the newly generated nuclei having the N by P ratio is greater than that of the parent. And for the beta decay, N by P ratio decreases. But there is one more type of the emission, that is for lighter nuclei having the N by P ratio is very low, undergo the positron emission to increase the N by P ratio for the stable nuclei. And you know that the positron means, positron, it is a positively charged electron. And Certain nuclei capture the orbital electron to increase their n by p ratio. So now we are moving into the some of the example. Here you can see the radium, Ra, radium, mass number 226. That is n by p ratio. It will emit alpha particle and n by p ratio increases. We will get radon having the mass number 222. So that emission is, the possible emission is the alpha emission. And for the thorium atomic the mass number 231, it will emit the electron or beta particle, and we will get protactinium having the mass number 231. And we have already discussed that some of the nuclei emit positron to increase their n by p ratio, and this is the example, carbon 11 emit positron and we will get barium 11, and the emission is the positron. Positron is represented by the positively charged electron E plus. And for the barium, Ba, barium, mass number 133, barium capture it orbital electron and to form the cesium having the mass number 133. So these are about the n by p ratio and the nuclear stability. This topic is very important. Please remember these examples. Thank you.